items that I'd like to visit with you about this evening. Let's start with an update on our sales and use tax. The figures that you have represent the first 10 months of our current fiscal year. The most recent collection period includes the last 2 weeks of February and estimations for the first 2 weeks of March. And of course, that means we have very limited financial information concerning the impact of the current COVID-19 situation. For the year, our sales tax collections are up a little more than 6%, which compares to slightly down from 6.6 a month ago. Use tax collections actually increased a little for the year to about 11.4%. That's up from 10.5%, which really reflects an increase in online sales. Our combined sales and use tax numbers for the first 10 months is 7.1%, down slightly from the 7.4% total at the end of last month. However, as we all know, all of these numbers compare very favorably with our 2% annual growth projection in the budget for sales tax and the 5% growth projection for use tax. So when we get the next set of data, we will start to see a little bit more of what we need to take a look at. So next month, we'll see where we stand. The second item is an update on the railroad quiet zone. The contractor for this project is Rudy Construction, and they will be installing conduit both under and around the Burlington Northern tracks at Danforth before the end of April, in order to meet the deadline for the railroad to finish installing the communication cable. The contractor will then begin the median improvements portion of the project at Sorghum Mill during the next week, the week of May 4th. And I think Casey is sending out a press release today that the Sorghum Mill will be closed at the track starting May 5th, a week from tomorrow, for about a 3-week period for this project. The current schedule identifies the end of October for the completion of this construction, and our people will be working very closely, not only with the railroad people, but also with the Federal Railroad Administration during the entire second part of this project, so that they can certify the quiet zone as quickly as possible after construction is finished. Just as a reminder, the total estimated cost of this project is about $4 million. It is entirely the city's responsibility, and our funding comes from the 2000 capital improvement sales tax. The third item is an update on the city and the Edmond Public Schools Tennis Center. Progress continues towards final completion of this joint project as the contractor, who is Key Construction, recently enclosed the indoor courts and installed all the indoor and outdoor lighting. All the interior doors, other interior lights, cabinet hardware, lockers and bathrooms will soon be completed as well. Some of the outdoor courts are now being resurfaced, but the recent rains have slowed that to some degree. This project is targeted for completion in June. The city and the Edmond Public Schools are equally sharing the expenses, with the bulk of the city's half of the funding coming from the 2017 repurposed capital improvement sales tax. And then the fourth item is an update on our intelligent transportation system, or ITS. I think it's always helpful to start with a definition of this so that people understand what we're talking about. ITS includes the use of field devices, communications infrastructure, and computer systems to enhance transit safety and mobility during congested periods, construction activities, maintenance activities, and traffic collisions and other emergencies. The phase two of this project is nearing completion. Phase two includes 22 signalized intersections in 3 school zones along Broadway, Danforth, and Covell. When the current testing of the fiber cable is completed, the Ethernet switches will be installed and tested to ensure communication between the intersection and our new traffic management center downtown. This project is tentatively scheduled for completion around the end of May. ODOT is administering the project and providing 80% of the funding. The total estimated project cost is close to $7 million. The city's 20% share is coming from the 2000 capital improvement sales tax. Good news on the phase three project. It has been approved now for 80% ODOT funding, and that ODOT funding in that project is estimated to be about $9.2 million. It will include 22 intersections on 15th Street from I-35 to Santa Fe and on Kelly from Danforth to 33rd.